Hi kids, it's Reverend James here at Children's Time. Today is a very special day in the church calendar. Today is called Transfiguration Sunday. It's the day where we remember the day Jesus went up the mountain with some of his friends, Peter, James, and John, and he was transfigured, he was transformed. He appeared to become dazzlingly bright. And it draws to a close the season that we've been in, the season of Epiphany, which means that this Wednesday is Ash Wednesday and marks the beginning of Lent. So whenever it's Ash Wednesday, the Tuesday immediately before is Pancake Tuesday, a day when traditionally people would use up all the butter and milk and things like that in their stores and make pancakes to celebrate one last time before Lent, which was a much more serious and sort of somber time of fasting. But today we're going to focus on the Transfiguration. Now, I used to get books from my great aunt who lived in Victoria. She would send me books for my birthday. And one year she sent me this Magic Eye book. I don't have it handy with me, but I want you to check out these magic eye pictures. So it's kind of a weird design that you look at, but if you look closely in a certain way, a 3D image will come out, what looks like a 3D image. Now, often what I've had to do is, because your eyes tend to focus on one specific point, but you can still see things out of your periphery, you can still see out of the corner of your eye, part of the key is to seeing these pictures is to be able to see them in your periphery. So what I would often do is I'd focus in on the picture close up with my eyes. And then you can see the 3D image. It's a bit difficult with a screen instead of an actual book, but check out these three examples. So the cool thing I find about these magic eye pictures is that it teaches us that how important perspective is. Perspective is seeing things from a different angle, either physically or from an idea standpoint, how we think about things, thinking about things from a different perspective. Now, if you hold your hand in front of your face and close one of your eyes, and then switch, you see your hand from a different perspective. And that's kind of like the magic eye pictures, whatever. That's kind of what Jesus was trying to teach people when he was here, to see people from a different perspective. Because we often see people and we judge them based on our culture, our preconceived notions, but Jesus wants us all to see people from God's perspective, to see people as human beings who are lovable, who are loved, and amazing in their own way. Another example of perspective is if you go outside at night and look at the stars, sometimes you'll see a star out of the periphery of your vision. You see it out of the corner of your eye, but then you look straight at it and you can't see it anymore. Well, that's because the cells that are at the back of your eye, on your retina, are different. And the ones in the middle of the retina are designed for bright lights, and the ones on the exterior are designed for dim lights. So if a star is really dim, you can actually only see it using the cells in your eye on the periphery. So you can't look right at it in order to see it. As soon as you do, the light is switched to the different cells, and those cells only pick up bright light, and so they can't pick up the dim light. Just another interesting example of how shifting our perspectives helps us see things that Maybe we couldn't see we're there in the first place. So Jesus goes up this mountain with his friends, Peter, James, and John, and they see him differently. They see Jesus from a different perspective. They see him transfigured. Here's the story. Check this out.
It's time for a Bible story. This story happened about 2,000 years ago when Jesus was here on the earth. One day, Jesus went up to a high mountain and brought a few of his disciples with him, Peter, James, and John.
Nice, going on a little hiking trip, huh? See the great outdoors, climb a mountain, maybe do a little fishing of men. Get it?
Yeah, I get it. But that's not why they went up onto the mountain. It was way more important than just a hiking trip. Jesus wanted to show them something incredible. When they got up to the top of the mountain, Jesus' appearance changed. The Bible says that his face shone bright like the sun, and his clothes became white as light.
Whoa, I hope they brought their sunglasses, or they'd be all like, my eyes!
Yeah, sunglasses weren't really a thing back then.
Right, they probably just got all squinty then, huh?
Probably. But then something else happened. Two other men appeared before them and started talking to Jesus.
Wait, hold up. Who are these guys? Where'd they come from?
The other two men were Moses and the prophet Elijah.
Whoa, wait a minute. Weren't those guys around, like, way earlier than Jesus was on the earth? Okay, you're getting my timelines all mixed up. This is some straight-up Infinity War time travel and next-level multiverse stuff.
Calm down. It's not that complicated. Yes, Moses and Elijah were both alive a long time before Jesus was on earth. But they appeared on the mountain with Jesus that day.
Okay, what happened next? I bet Peter, James, and John were totally amped to see that happen.
They totally were. In fact, Peter wanted to build three memorials right there on the mountain. One for Jesus, one for Moses, and one for Elijah.
Classic Peter.
But right after he said that, something else happened. A bright cloud covered them, and a voice from the cloud said, "This is my son, with whom I am well pleased. Listen to him."
Wait, was that God's voice that said that?
You got it.
Oh man, that would be pretty powerful to hear.
Oh, it definitely was. When the voice of God said that about Jesus, the disciples fell face down on the ground, terrified.
Well, yeah, I've done that just when my mom calls my name from across the house.
I know, right? Especially when they use your middle name. That's when you know it's game over.
Okay, so we got Jesus shining like the sun, Moses and Elijah hanging out, glowing clouds, the voice of God. What happened next?
As the disciples were on the ground, Jesus came up and touched them and said, "Don't be afraid. Get up." When they looked up, everything else was gone, and it was just Jesus standing before them. Then, as they traveled down the mountain, Jesus instructed them not to tell anyone about what they saw until after his resurrection.
Okay, hold on. I've got a few questions.
Understandable, and so did the disciples. They asked Jesus about what they just saw, and Jesus helped them understand that it was just a glimpse of what would happen in the future. He would come back one day in his glorified body and bring about a new kingdom on the earth.
Dude, that sounds incredible. I can't wait for that.
Yeah, me neither, dude. The end.
So why did this event happen? It's kind of a mysterious event. Well, one of the reasons was that Jesus was preparing his friends, his disciples, for the time when he would suffer, when he would be arrested, when he'd have to carry the cross, and he would eventually die on the cross. And Jesus wants to prepare the disciples for this, to understand it, but also to remember when all seems lost, when they're so sad with Jesus' suffering and death, to remember the transfiguration and to remember everything is meant to lead to glory, to lead to God's love and life. And that sometimes suffering and pain are just part of the process of getting to that glory. The whole event, this teaching, is an invitation for us to see things in our lives from a different perspective. First example, big example, we can get really down and sad when all we can think about in our lives is what is bad about them, what is missing, what is wrong. Gets us really down, can get me down really badly. But if you take a moment and think about things that are good, what is there, what you do have, it shifts your perspective and it can make you feel maybe not completely happy, but a little less sad. It helps us see things in a different way. So take, for example, the pandemic. There's a lot of stuff to be sad about right now, to be sure. We can't see our family and friends. We have to keep distance. There's a lot of things that we can't do that we used to be able to. and that can get us super down. But when we think of the things we can still do, even if it's as basic as we have food to eat, we have a roof over our heads when it's so cold outside and a warm bed, hopefully we get to see our friends at school sometimes. And there's so many different things we can do on the internet now. Just a few years ago, we couldn't do so many of the things that we can do now. So to be able to see things from that perspective helps you at least feel a little less sad and hopefully a little more happy. Or take, for example, other people. So often in our world, we see other people who are different and we don't like that. We think it's scary or we even get angry at them. Why aren't you like us? Why are you different? And so much conflict in our world and suffering is caused by that. But if we look at one another and see how we're similar, even people who live on the other side of the world, we all have things in common. We all love to laugh. We all love great food. We all just want to be loved. If we can see how we're similar, think of how much better the world could be. Or even of ourselves. Sometimes we see ourselves and compare ourselves to others and think, well, I don't have what they have. I don't look like they do. I can't do what they do. And that can get us really down. But first of all, if we're able to look at ourselves and see the gifts that we do have, that we're able to do amazing things, that can make us happy. But also perspective, right? So you look at someone who's like a great sports star or something and think, well, I can't play hockey like they do, or I can't play basketball like they do. We have to remember that everyone who is great at something started not very good at it. They worked, they practiced, they built themselves up to be able to hone their skills. And when we see them from that perspective, we think, okay, well, if I put the work in, if I put my mind to doing something, I can achieve that too. Just one last thought about perspective. One of my favorite movies of all time is Mary Poppins, and in particular, this scene. Check this out.
Shall we begin?
It is a game, isn't it, Mary Poppins?
Well, it depends on your point of view. You see, in every job that must be done, there is an element of fun. You find the fun, and snap! The job's a game. And every task you undertake becomes a piece of cake, a lark, a spree. It's very clear to see that a spoonful of sugar helps the medicine go down. The medicine go down, medicine go down. Just a spoonful of sugar helps the medicine go down in a most delightful way.
So Mary Poppins invites these two kids to see things from a different perspective. They see their chores, their need to clean up their room as something awful. Ugh, I don't want to do that. That's boring. That's hard work. But remember, she says, in every job that must be done, there is an element of fun. You find the fun and snap, the job's a game. So it's being able to see things in our lives, even the hard work we have to do, even sometimes the things we don't really want to do, to see them from a different perspective. To see what's good in them and fun in them, and to be able to have fun doing it. So my friends, Jesus invites us today to have a closer look at things in our world, in ourselves, in our friendships, our family, and see what maybe we don't see at first glance, to take a deeper look and to see what goodness and love God reveals to us every day. So we'll end our children's time by praying together the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Have a great week, everyone. Take care. God bless you. Bye.